Wireless computing is a rapidly emerging technology providing users with network connectivity without being tethered off of a wired network. Wireless local area networks, that is WLANs, like their wired counterparts, are being developed to provide high bandwidth to the user in limited geographical area. WLANs are being studied as an alternative to the high installation and maintenance cost incurred by traditional additions, deletions, and changes experienced in wired LAN infrastructures. Physical and environmental necessity is another driving factor in favor of WLANs. Typically, new building architectures are planned with network connectivity factored into the building requirements. However, users inhabiting existing buildings may find it infeasible to retrofit existing structures for wired network access. Examples of structures that are very difficult to wire include concrete buildings, traditional floors, manufacturing facilities, warehouses, and historical buildings. Lastly, the operational environment may not accommodate a wired network, or the network may be temporary and operational for a very short time, making the installation of a wired network impractical. Examples where this is true include ad hoc networking needs such as conference registration centers, campus classrooms, emergency relief centers, and tactical military environments. Ideally, users of wireless networks will want to the same services and capabilities that they have commonly come to expect with wired networks. However, to meet these objectives, the wireless community faces certain challenges and constraints that are not imposed on their wired counterparts. Frequency allocation. Operation of wireless network requires that all users operate on a common frequency band. Frequency bands for particular uses must typically be approved and licensed in each country, which is a time-consuming process due to the high demand for available radio spectrum. Interference and reliability. Interference in wireless communications can be caused by simultaneous transmissions, that is, collisions, by two or more sources sharing the same frequency band. Collisions are typically the result of multiple stations waiting for the channel to become idle and then beginning transmission at the same time. Collisions are also caused by the hidden terminal problem, where a station, believing the channel is idle, and begins transmission without successfully detecting the presence of the transmission already in progress. Interference is also caused by multipath fading, which is characterized by random amplitude and phase fluctuations at receiver. The reliability of the communications channel is typically measured by the average bit error rate, that is BER. For packetized voice, packet loss rate on the order of 10 raised to minus 2 are generally acceptable. And for uncoded data, a BER of 10 raised to minus 5 is regarded as acceptable. Automatic repeat request, that is ARQ, and forward error correction, that is FEC, are used to increase reliability. Security. In a wired network, the transmission medium can be physically secured and access to the network is easily controlled. A wireless network is more difficult to secure since the transmission medium is open to anyone within the geographical range of a transmitter. Data privacy is usually accomplished over a radio medium using encryption. While encryption of wireless traffic can be achieved, it is usually at the expense of increased cost and decreased performance. Power consumption. Typically, devices connected to a wired network are powered by the local 110 or 230 volt commercial power provided in a building depending upon the country. Wireless devices, however, are meant to be portable and or mobile and are typically battery powered. Therefore, devices must be designed to be very energy efficient, resulting in sleep modes and low power displays, causing users to make cost versus performance and cost versus capability trade-offs. Human safety. Research is ongoing to determine whether radio frequency, that is RF transmissions from radio and cellular phones, are linked to human illness. Networks should be designed to minimize the power transmitted by network devices. For infrared, that is IR, WLAN systems, optical transmitters must be designed to prevent vision impairment. Mobility. Unlike wired terminals, which are static when operating on the network, one of the primary advantages of wireless terminals is freedom of mobility. Therefore, system designs must accommodate hands-off between transmission boundaries and route traffic to mobile users. Throughput. The capacity of WLANs should ideally approach that of their wired counterparts. However, due to physical limitations and limited available bandwidth, WLANs are currently targeted to operate at data rates between 1 to 20 Mbps. To support multiple transmission simultaneously, spread spectrum techniques are frequently employed.